Hi guys, Keith Sparks here, and today for Foam Rolling Friday, we're going to talk about two specific muscles, the glute medius and the glute minimus. Now the front part of these fibers actually attach to the front part of the hip. They come up and around and attach to this upper part of our pelvis, so they make this little triangle right here. When we see weakness in these two muscles, we'll see a shift in the pelvis. Now you'll typically find this with runway models and anyone that watches Happy Gilmore. A great test you can do at home is the 6-inch step down that we talked about in the adductor series video. These two muscles, a lot of times when we see this shift, we think of strength training the muscles, and that's definitely right on. You should be always trying to strength train any form of problem when we sway through the frontal plane. Now, recent research is starting to indicate that doing some form of manual therapy, soft tissue therapy, and exercise together produces better results than either one alone. The reason for this is it gives our brain more sensory input into these problem areas to figure out what the body needs and to get it fixed and addressed. So, I'm gonna show you some tricks with foam rolling these two muscles. Now, as we said, these muscles are roughly right in here. They're high up. They're not low like you would typically think with the glutes whenever you talk about the glutes. A lot of athletic sports and events occur with the hip in about 30 degrees of flexion. So if these muscles run from the hip up to the pelvis, they run about that angle, which is relatively 30 degrees, which is the landing position for the contact leg with the ground. So when you foam roll, I want you to think about getting the hip in about 30 degrees of flexion. And what you're going to do is you're just going to rest right in here. If this is fine, what I want you to think about doing is actually, and I'm going to contract my body, and I'm going to try to push it into the floor. And from here, you roll slightly forward, try to find an area, and slightly back. Now, a lot of people won't feel it directly straight, the pelvis and the hips stacked on top of each other. You have to roll a little bit forward or a little bit back. It gets better into the anterior or posterior fibers, the glute medius and the glute minimus. You can also do it with a straight leg. That's perfectly fine. It's just a lot of athletic events occur with 30 degrees of hip flexion. Either way is perfectly great. From here, this is a little more advanced. If you can keep this top leg contacted with the ground, great, go for it. And move the hip back and move the hip forward and see if this feels different between the two. When you do this though, never try to lose that neutral spine. You don't want to be hinging in the low back. You want to keep the low back stiff, pressurized, and moving the hip. So give these tips a shot and let us know what you think. Thanks.